sun is setting and you're right here by my side. And the movie is playing, but we won't be watching tonight. Every look, every touch, every touch makes me wanna give you my heart. I've been crushing on you, baby. Stay right where you are. Cause I never lose, you can James Dean in his eyes. Puts his lips on my neck, makes me wanna give him my body. I'll be falling for you, baby, and I just can't stop. Cause I never knew, I never knew you could have your hands.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
It begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable.
Take a moment to consider the following, as it will guide you through the various twists and turns that may appear during your stay at Hackett's Quarry. What you see here are quick time events, or QTEs, which will help you to act at just the right time. Watch your step. Hackett's Quarry can be a dangerous place if you're not paying attention to your surroundings. Take your eye off the ball, and it could spell disaster. The path you tread is yours to choose, but that doesn't mean there won't be obstacles along the way.
Oh, heads up. Yeah, honey, nice catch.
Thank you. Man, the roads are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Yeah. You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America. Goodbye, hot dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Oh my god. Okay, just get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it.
Were there any directions on the flyer?
No, just a fake bunch of kids faking it around a fake fire pit.
Checks out.
Everything okay?
Yeah, all good. Hey, eyes on the road, mister.
What?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, still in one piece.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No, no, Max, it wasn't a bear.
What was it?
I think it was a person.
Lou, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like really close, but maybe we didn't. What is it?
I really effed this car up.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is.
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, yeah, okay.
It's not so bad.
My mom's gonna kill me. Thanks, hon.
Yeah. Do you need a hand?
Yeah, actually, if you could just shine a light right here.
Here you go.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire.
And then picture yourself curling up in front of a big old space heater.
Anywhere's better than here.
Where are you going?
Just over here.
Just stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
What? You're not the boss of me.
I just don't want you wandering off on your own.
Excuse me.
That's not what I meant.
Yeah, it better not be.
I'm sorry. I really got to concentrate for a second, okay?
Okay, yes. Look, I think there's someone down there, okay?
What's that?
They could be hurt. I'm going to go check it out. Good idea, Laura. So thoughtful of you. Rose.
stylist. Dog boy. Yikes. This is too weird.
Hey, why are you shouting? What?
Oh my God. Silas.
What the hell was that?
Car. Now. Now!
Okay.
Did you see it?
No, but I heard something. Let's just get out of here.
Come on!
Oh, God, I thought you said you checked it.
I did check it, and it was fine. Honey, I know you're on edge, but you gotta calm down, okay?
I am not on edge, Max. I'm freaking the fuck out.
It was probably just an animal or something.
No, it wasn't an animal. You didn't see it. It was a woman.
Lord, this isn't helping, all right? Go! There we go. We're good. See?
Please just get us out of here.
Okay. I'm trying.
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Jeez!
Oh!
Fuck!
Oh my God, my heart just exploded.
Roll it down.
Hi, officer. How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
You folks want to tell me what happened here?
Take a moment to consider the following, as it will guide you through the various twists and turns that may appear during your stay at Hackett's Quarry. What you see here are quick time events, or QTEs, which will help you to act at just the right time. Watch your step. Hackett's Quarry can be a dangerous place if you're not paying attention to your surroundings. Take your eye off the ball, and it could spell disaster. The path you tread is yours to choose, but that doesn't mean there won't be obstacles along the way. At certain times throughout the night, opportunities will present themselves, giving you the chance to take matters into your own hands. It is worth noting that they are only suggestions. You don't have to act upon them. In fact, sometimes it's better not to. Hackett's Quarry is full of twists and turns, unknown paths, and unexplored wonders. With each step taken, you tread a path of your own, matched with its very own consequences. There will be moments throughout your stay that show you that the choices you've made, the path you've chosen, could have gone another way. At Hackett's Quarry, there's no such thing as the wrong way. But be warned. Some paths are more dangerous than others.
Something jumped out right in front of the car and we didn't want to hit it, so we swerved and now here we are.
Something jumped out?
I'm sorry, it was so dark and it happened so fast and they were gone.
They? Ma'am, did you hit someone?
No, God no, of course not. You know, I mean, I don't know.
Sir? Keep the car running.
Sir?
Is this guy like the all-time scariest cop?
I don't know. This is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Now, you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp. We're new counselors.
You're one night early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out, you know? I mean, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold their navigation skills and got us completely lost.
You're not gonna make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight. Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am, you're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
I With all due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because I told you to go to the motel.
Okay, I just don't understand what the problem...
Ma'am, please step out of the vehicle.
Whoa.
What? Why?
Officer, she didn't do anything.
Ma'am, if you wouldn't mind stepping out of the vehicle, I would just like to show you a route on your map there.
Okay. For sure.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
It's okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, we... are right about here. Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning. Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road.
Wait, but what if there's someone out there?
Yeah, I'll have a look. Good night.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
That guy was giving me major weirdo
vibes. The dude needed like at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Nice to meet you.
Let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here.
Mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's Quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible.
Yeah.
Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
What?
20's... debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done here.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car, and this is a complete waste
Why
of time.
Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll beat the car.
Max, come on. Max, don't be a dick.
I'm sorry.
Is anybody home? What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Laura, there's no one here. Come on.
Just give me one more minute, okay? Be right back. I'm gonna get some help. Max! Max, get over here!
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the lock. Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know, you just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking, I am.
Let me see. There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so... You sure?
Yeah, saw it online.
Damn. You need a hand?
Yeah.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
Hello? Are you hurt?
Do you exist? Hey, be careful.
Max?
Hun, maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Hey, it's been kind of a night, you know? Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Max?
Fly me to the moon and let me me play among the stars. Let me know what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Hello, my friend. Welcome to the show. We are friends, aren't we? I've waited for you. I've waited. Yes. So I do hope our time together proves enlightening. There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting, yes. And terrifying. But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other. You didn't find anything, and so I've nothing to show you. You need to look harder. The cards are out there. If you don't help me, how can I help you? We're supposed to be friends. You said so yourself. Search harder. Only you can find them. There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover on which I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Peace and love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
You know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're just kids. You know, they'll get over it.
Uh-huh. Like they'll get over Emma.
What? That's not the same thing.
Oh, so that's not why you're in a bad mood.
I'm not in a bad... Oh, you know what? We had our last night together, and we're cool.
Oh, yeah. So cool that you're never gonna see your special little boo-boo bear ever again.
Jeez, Chris, you heard that?
Oh, come on, dude. The cabin walls are made of Band-Aids and rat turds.
Okay, I get it. Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before, right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Be a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're just kids. You know, they'll get over it.
Uh-huh. Like they'll get over Emma?
What? That's not the same thing.
Oh, so that's not why you're in a bad mood.
I'm not in a bad... Oh, you know what? We had our last night together, and we're cool.
Oh, yeah. So cool that you're never gonna see your special little boo-boo bear ever again.
Jeez, Chris, you heard that?
Oh, come on, dude. The cabin walls are made of Band-Aids and rat turds.
Okay, I get it. Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before, right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Beat a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Hey, what are you listening to? Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke. Good to know. Doesn't kill you will make you stronger. Not in the mood, sign. Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan, come
it's
on.
Broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's.
I gotta get the last bags
What's
in there. Come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just.
Dylan,
frozen.
Please.
Sorry, bud.
Cool. Thanks, guys.
dipshits bolted it? Really? Skill. Ugh. Horror. I hate horror. Man, that's a bad place to get stuck. Thank you.
All right. Got the bags.
Great. All by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my god, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Oh, okay, so now I'm the one who's not telling the whole story, huh?
Oh, well, this is the bait I just gotta take, Jake. Oh, sorry, I just got so distracted about that rhyme, I forgot what we
Oh, no. You were telling me how you totally have a thing for Ryan.
Wait, are we talking about Ryan, the sailing instructor with the sexy brooding loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all?
Ah, sexy, huh?
Hottest at camp, by far.
Okay, sure.
Look, it was all settled by the girls in bunk 7, like, second day of camp. It goes Ryan, me, of course, then Dylan, Emma, Abby.
Okay.
Nick, and then Mr. H, and...
Okay, are you almost finished? Please?
Yep, that's it. That's everyone. So she really just dumped her ass, huh?
I don't... Okay. Her whole thing is like, how are we gonna make this work? Different schools, blah, blah, blah. My whole thing is like, you know, maybe long distance, blah, 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 blah. And she was just like, Jacob.
She gave you the look, huh?
Yeah, do not pass go.
Man, she just got you wrapped all the way around that dainty little finger of hers. How does she do it?
Okay, you know what? Maybe you're right. Maybe she does have, like, this superpower over me. But you know what? Maybe I like it.
Oh, likes it. Check. Totally not in denial. Check.
Oh, okay. Wow, the fumes of jealousy are just stifling over here.
Excuse me?
I'm just saying, I guess some girls don't have what it takes to hang with the big dog.
You're a real charmer, you know that?
That's right, because I could charm the pants off a snake.
That's maybe the dumbest thing you've ever said.
No, I've definitely said dumber.
Yep.
Okay, so are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you yet, and you're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up. Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was like a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. Guess we'll just have to find out. This looks important. Shit. I will hook you right back up tomorrow, okay? Pinky promise.
Up here, my dudes.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please. Don't.
Go along.
Oh, Nick! Boom. Oh, there it is.
Oh, ooh. Man, good sight.
Freak.
Oh. Oh.
Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. I'm surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
Okay, well, at least I had a relationship this summer.
Ooh, damn, now we burned.
Yeah, well, maybe not everyone is looking for a hookup.
Okay, okay, let's all put our little dicks away and get this show on the road, huh?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah, keep dreaming, Junior.
Hey there, party bear.
Status report?
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
Oh boy, you're about to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump.
Door's locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. Then by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get into trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? He'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh my God, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts!
Aw. This was little Izzy's.
I wanna play a game!
Yeah, you can probably just stay here, you creepy little thing.
gonna be weird not waking up to Dylan's morning announcements.
Why would this place be in the news? Thank you. Dylan is not going to be happy that the kids just left this year. I'll tell Chris about it when we see him. Can't believe I'm actually gonna miss all those lumpy, loose springs. I don't think anyone knocked Caitlin out of first place all summer.
Ready to roll?
Let's do it. Finally.
Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
Aw. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there. Nice steering, Tex.
Jinkies. Okay, so hypothetically, if I were to put myself out there, what if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school like 4 states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
But that's us. You and Nick. Could be different. When do you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up!
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp?
Sure, what's the victory?
2 months.
No technology.
I kind of thought it was nice to be offline.
Ugh, I didn't. Plus, my subs need me.
You know what? I actually believe you.
Abby, was that a compliment?
Your charm is infectious. What can I say? I'd subscribe.
You better. As soon as you get home, sub, share, smash that like button. The Holy Trinity.
Okay, well, now I'm really regretting it.
Oh, no, you love me. My favorite spot?
The fire pit?
The island. Mad secluded, right? Is that smoke?
Should we tell someone?
It looks pretty contained. It's probably just Mr. H burning some stuff before, you know, he closes camp for the summer.
Yeah. Speaking of which, we should probably, you know, get back.
Oh, yeah. Worried Nick's, you know, gonna leave without you?
Well, no, they're probably, like, all waiting for us.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Everyone, yeah. Nick, waiting for you. All... Everyone, see you.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so... Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody own phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is like patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No.
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go. And...
ew.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Ignore her, please.
Let's go. Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here, let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you.
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you.
We can both take care of our own bag, thank you.
Cool.
Abby, do you need...
Yeah.
Can I...
Thank you.
Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh, yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
I think it's called How to Mind Your Own Business. You should listen to it.
Ghosts.
Ghosts?
Yeah, well, all sorts of cryptozoology, really. The episode I was listening to was actually about this place.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The one that you were talking about to the kids at the campfire.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Yes.
What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
If I did, would I be asking, dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and then this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son. Or kill you. Or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Haga Haggett's Corey.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, bro.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time you told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for life.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
Well, hop to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
We had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up. Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to press the ladies with all his ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Ugh. Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Come on, that's like super unchill.
Hey, dude, I'm like the chillest flipping bro in the whole world, man.
I just need some tunes for the ride, man.
All right, that's enough.
5 minutes? Like 5 minutes, that's all I need, man.
You said no, Dylan.
Okay, yeah, I know, but I was just...
I'll meet you at the van, okay? So, Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
Uh-oh. I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry.
Hello?
Kids are kids. It'd only be so much here, though.
They're almost out of here, all right?
You're cutting it pretty close. We don't want to have...
Just hold your damn horses, all right? Everything's A-OK on this end.
Bobby and I are geared up. If he's in the area, we'll get him.
This is a waste of time.
You know it, I know it.
No, should I have?
He's gone quiet.
Probably staying out of the way. Speaking of which, the longer you keep me on this damn phone, the longer it's gonna take me to get rid of these damn kids. Yeah. Of course. Adios.
Sorry, I wasn't listening. I was just like waiting. Like, I mean, I heard. I didn't hear what you were.
We're cool, champ. Just. Come on, it's sorry I pushed you out like that.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No, end of summer, busy, you know. Anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah, it was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Right.
You know, whether or not I should, like... leave my sister with my grandparents, since I'd have to live on campus, you know, and my mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own. You know, our family's small enough as it is.
Well, family is important, Ryan. Dang it.
This is just important to me.
You know what's important to me, Ryan? Trying to run a successful summer camp. I'm still trying to make up for the losses from last year. Terrified kids are bad for business. Phone calls I get from scandalized parents, nightmares, thumb-sucking, bedwetting. Think about that the next time you're flipping some yarn about the
Hag of Hackett's.
Just think next time, champ. Use the old skull muscle.
It was just a fun story that weirdo kid told me last month.
Hey, there's no weirdo here. At Hackett's Quarry, everyone's their own brand of cool. You counselors gotta be the responsible ones. Keep the kids happy. Keep the kids safe. So knock it off.
Yeah, of course. I mean, we are. Seriously, Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Why?
It's getting dark, Ryan, and it's not safe to drive in the dark. And safety is the first step towards fun. Just give me a minute. Where in the good goddamn are they?
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? They sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee, well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her. They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
Actually, could have used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage all right. But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed them. Unlocked the van, put the keys in my pocket, came in the office. Right where I left them. Let's skedaddle. Make sure they're all ready to go. For real this time.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
You shouldn't have turned it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell in the minivan. Get on with our respective lives. Move it, let's go. What's the problem?
Ugh, dude, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr. H.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, dude, it's just like kaput.
All right, let me try.
What, dude, I'm telling you, all right, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
What the fuck, dude?
Enough, both of you. Shit, come on.
All right,
come
dude, on. Chill, dude.
Holy shit! Everybody back, now! Jacob, wait!
I got this. Ow, jeez, dude, I was trying to help.
Okay.
Look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just spend one more night here.
No! Just stop. Let me think.
Ah!
Okay. Damn it. You're right, yeah.
What?
Yeah, you're right. Hey, Brian. Come here for a sec. Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay.
I'll be back first thing in the morning, and we'll get you all on the road. You just have to keep everyone inside. Can you promise me you'll do that?
Yeah, sure. We'll stay inside.
Attaboy. Lock the doors. And for God's sake, keep the noise down!
So, what was that about?
He said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? What are we supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside, like he said.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or we could do something else.
No. We should really listen to what Chris told us to do.
Of course.
Who cares what Chris told us to do? He's not our boss anymore. P-A-R-T. Why the fuck not? All right, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for all time.
Oh, dude. Fuck yes. I'm in. Nick, you're in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Dylan's in, obviously. My man. Caitlin?
I go where my people need me.
Yeah, okay. Em, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm in. Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent we stay in the lodge.
He was just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
I don't think he was trying to freak us out, Jacob. I think he was really freaked out by something.
Jesus Christ.
Chris seemed real serious about this, guys.
Just say you're in, man. Come on, one last night.
Yeah,
dude, he won't even know.
I promised.
No, dude. It's all good, all right? We get it. You know, you don't want to disappoint Daddy.
Yeah, well, someone's got to give a shit.
Oh.
You know what? I don't even care what you guys do.
Oh.
I'm doing what Chris told me to do.
Ryan, come on, man. Wait.
All right. Hacketeers. Party planning committee. Let's do this. Okay. First things first. Nick and Abby, you go get some firewood. Em and I will go to the stores for some supplies. And Dylan, you just, figure out how to charge the phones for something. All right, let's do this.
Thank you.
I was hoping you'd come back to me. Let's see what you've found. Temperance. To be balanced, to consume in moderation, or to indulge in excess. Temperance. Take it or leave it. But remember, sometimes with temperance comes deferred gratification. There's more I can show you, if you like. I was hoping you'd say that. You'd better be going. It's still early and the moon is bright, but time won't wait. Not for those with a story to tell. Be careful. Look out for yourselves. And look out for my cards.
Stranded in the great American wild with nothing but our wits to guide us. Will humanity prevail, or will we grow ravenous and resort to eating the flesh of the deceased like I saw in that one plane crash movie? First course, filet au Jacob. Rich and full-bodied, this rare beefcake may leave an irritating taste lingering on the palate. An acquired taste, some would say. Wow.
What?
Looks like you're trying to thread a needle with a packet of loose sausages.
Oh my god, I'm almost done, okay? Jesus Christ. And for the record, your analogies are very hurtful.
Okay, I'm almost there. One second. Whoa!
And scene.
Well, I mean, I could have kicked it.
You loosened it for me.
Okay. So, if I were a beer, where would I be hiding? Beep, 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 beep.
What
beep,
are you doing?
Beep. Oh, it's my beer dar. Helps me dar for beers.
Huh. How am I just noticing how super lame you are?
What? But it's my beer dar, dude.
I'm gonna go over here. Wow, the kids really wiped this place out. Mr. H loved his accessories. I think it's locked. Don't know what I was expecting.
Oh. Oh, hell yeah! Oh! Jackpot! Hey, check out my giant melons.
Oh.
See, you just cut a hole in it?
Mm-hmm.
You pour in your vodka. It's party time.
You pour the vodka right in it.
Yeah. It's the most fun you could have with a hole in a watermelon. Or, well, second most.
Okay. I'm gonna leave you two alone and go look for some more party supplies.